Guys, welcome back. In this part of today's lesson, I'm going to give you a bit of vocabularies about the house, and also I'm gonna describe my house to you in order for you to be able to do the same later on. So, let's start first of all. Where do you live? Dove vivi? Do you live in a house or do you live in an apartment? Vivo in una villa. I live in a house. Or I live in a villa. Vivo in un appartamento. I live in an apartment. And then, do you live by yourself? Do you live with your family, with your partner? I live by myself is vivo da solo or da sola if you're a girl. Vivo con la mia famiglia. I live with my family. Convivo con il mio compagno. Convivo con la mia compagna. I live with my partner. How many rooms are there in your house? Quante stanze ci sono nella tua casa? Quante stanze ci sono nella tua casa? In my house there are whatever rooms. Nella mia casa ci sono X stanze, whatever is the number. Do you have a parquet or a carpet at home? In casa hai il parquet o la moquette? O la moquette. In realtà, actually, I've got tiles on the floor. Ho le mattonelle a terra. Le stanze, the rooms. Stanza is room. Rooms, stanze. It's a feminine noun. The entrance is ingresso. Bedroom, stanza da letto. And then we got a name for the kids' bedroom, so we call it stanzetta. Hallway, corridoio. Corridoio. And then there are different ways to call the living room. It could be salotto, salone, or soggiorno. It's up to you. Bathroom, bagno. I heard many foreign people in the past saying like dov'è il gabinetto? That is very wrong and sounds so weird, guys. It's not like that because gabinetto is the actual toilet, the water, okay? So next time you wanna ask for the bathroom, ask dov'è il bagno? Okay? That is much better. Kitchen. Cucina, storage room, sgabuzzino, sgabuzzino, backyard, giardino, vegetable garden is orto, so it's where you grow your veggies or fruit, orto. Balcony is balcone and terrace is terrazzo. So, the entrance, ingresso. In the entrance of my house there is a coat rack. Nell'ingresso di casa mia c'è un attaccapanni. Do you recognize the preposition nel? That's what we learned in the second video. Nel. Ci sono anche, there are also, una mensola, a shelf, una libreria, a bookshelf. E uno specchio, a mirror. Libreria is also the library, so the shop where you go to buy books, by the way. It's the same in Italian. Libreria is both bookshelf and library. I muri sono gialli, walls are yellow. Yellow is giallo, gialli. Gialli is plural. E il pavimento and the floor is white, è bianco. Non è molto grande, it's not very big, but it's cozy, ma è accogliente, accogliente. And that was the ingresso, the entrance. The bedroom. La stanza da letto, bedroom, è molto grande, it's very big. Il letto si trova al centro della stanza. The bed is in the middle of the room. Sul letto ci sono due cuscini. There are two pillows on the bed. Do you also recognize sul? Yep, you do. Well done. Ed un piumone. And a duvet. Ci sono anche due comodini nella stanza. There are two bedside tables as well in the bedroom, or in the room. E un armadio molto spazioso. And a very spacious wardrobe. Purtroppo, unfortunately, purtroppo, la stanza è buia. The room is dark. Perché non c'è una finestra. Because there is no window. Here I give you some words that you could also use to talk about the bedroom, like the bed sheet, il lenzuolo. The bed sheets, le lenzuola. La federa is the pillow case. Le federe are the pillow cases. Mattress is materasso. Materasso. La stanzetta, the kids' bedroom. La stanzetta è piccola, the kids' bedroom is small, e ha un letto a soppalco. And there is a loft bed, it has a loft bed. Sotto il letto a soppalco, under the loft bed, c'è una scrivania, there is a desk, con una piccola lampada, with a small lamp. Ci sono anche due armadi, there are also two wardrobes, usati come deposito, used as a storage, perché non ho uno sgabuzzino, because I don't have a storage room. Corridoio, hallway. In casa c'è un breve e stretto corridoio. In the house there is a short, breve, and narrow, stretto, hallway. Sui muri ci sono delle foto. There are some photos on the walls. Il bagno, the bathroom. Il bagno è piccolo. The bathroom is small. Ci sono mattonelle blu sui muri. There are blue tiles on the walls. Walls. On the walls. C'è un piccolo armadietto. There is a small cabinet. C'è una finestra. There is a window. Purtroppo, unfortunately, non c'è una vasca. There isn't a tub. Ma una doccia. But a shower. C'è un gabinetto, there is a toilet, e un lavandino, and a sink. And here I gave you some vocabularies about the bathroom. For example, spazzolino. Spazzolino is toothbrush. Dentifricio, toothpaste. Asciugamano, which I remember being the favorite Italian word of one of you members of the group, asciugamano. It sounds pretty funny now that I read it. Asciugamano is towel. Sapone, soap. Bagno schiuma, shower gel. Shampoo is shampoo. Balsamo, conditioner. Asciugacapelli, hair dryer. Asciugacapelli. Maybe this will become a new favorite for one of you. Spazzola is brush. Pettine, comb. Perfume is profumo. Toilet paper, carta, paper, igienica. Crema corpo, body lotion. And here I'll give you razor is rasoio. Oh, another one. Tappetino is a bath mat. Salone, salotto, saggiorno, wherever you want to call it, it's still a living room. Il soggiorno è la mia parte preferita della casa. The living room is my favorite part of the house. È molto grande e luminoso. It's very big and bright. Luminoso, bright. C'è un divano, there is a sofa, con due cuscini, with two cushions, una bella lampada, a nice lamp, una mensola, a shelf, ed una televisione, and a TV. Televisione, you could also say, ed una TV. C'è un bel tappeto, there is a nice carpet, actually more than carpet, I believe it's rug in English. There is a nice rug con sopra un tavolino, with a coffee table on top. Cucina, kitchen. La cucina è abbastanza grande e luminosa. The kitchen is quite big and bright. C'è una bella finestra, there is a nice window, con vista sul giardino, with garden view. Ho quattro mobili, I've got four cupboards, e quattro cassetti, and four drawers. C'è un lavandino, there is a sink, un tavolo, a table, quattro sedie, four chairs, un frigorifero, a fridge, ed un forno. And an oven. Purtroppo, unfortunately, non ho un microonde. I don't have a microwave, nor a dishwasher, né una lavastoviglie. And here are some words for you about the kitchen. By the way, guys, if there is some words that I did not include in my list and you'd like me to translate, just write them down in the comments. For any lesson, I'm talking about any lesson, just write it in the comment and I will write you the correct translation. Posate, cutlery. Forchetta, fork. Coltello, knife. Cucchiaio, spoon. And I want to add cucchiaino. Cucchiaino is a teaspoon. Cucchiaino. Tovagliolo, napkin. Tovaglia is a tablecloth. Macchinetta del caffè, not missing in any proper Italian house. Coffee machine. Tostapane, toaster. Bollitore, kettle. Mestolo, I had to look up for this English word, so forgive me if my pronunciation will be wrong. I have never heard of this. Ladle, mestolo. I can probably show it to you. This is mestolo. I'm not sure the English translation is right, so spare me if you say it. Scolapasta is a pasta drainer. Bicchiere. Is if it's both a cup or a glass. So it could be bicchiere di plastica is the plastic cup. Bicchiere is a normal glass, but you can also just say bicchiere. And cucchiaino, I already read that one. Balcone, balcony, terrazzo, terrace. Il balcone è molto grande e lungo. The balcony is very big and long. C'è anche un piccolo terrazzo. There is also a small terrace. Dove mi piace mangiare in estate. Where I like to eat in summer. Infatti c'è un tavolo. In fact, there is a table. Fuori al balcone, outside on the balcony, c'è anche la pattumiera. Pattumiera is the bin. There is the bin as well. E una cuccia per i miei cani. And a doghouse for my dogs. Giardino. Dal balcone c'è una scala che porta al giardino. Is there an accent or no? It's just my screen very dirty. Dal balcone c'è una scala che porta al giardino. From the balcony, dal balcone, there is a stair, c'è una scala that takes you to the garden. Che porta al giardino. Il mio giardino, my garden, my garden is very big, è molto grande. Da un lato, in one side, ho un orto, I've got a vegetable garden. E dall'altro lato, and in the other side, c'è il prato, there is the grass. Ok, and I think, yeah, that was it, so
Here, you remember that in the Facebook group you can download my notes so you can write down all these words that you've learned and practice describing your house. It's actually gonna be in your assignment, so you're gonna have to do that. So, thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Ciao!